Welcome to Pray With Me, a daily prayer time with Father Alphonse. Let us begin our prayer with the praying of the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech you, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ your Son was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Every Tuesday we have been praying for the end of COVID-19 and for people who have been affected with this virus and for people who have died, people who are on ventilators so that they could be healed and could come back to us. We pray for people who are affected by this virus here in our country and all over the world. We are continuing our Psalm 18. Yesterday we prayed the first part, and today we are praying from verse 21 to 35. Please join me in praying with me and with King David. The Lord acknowledged my righteousness, rewarded my clean hands, for I kept the ways of the Lord. I was not disloyal to my God, for his laws were all before me. His decrees I did not cast aside. I was honest toward him. I was on guard against sin. So the Lord rewarded my righteousness, the cleanness of toward the faithful, you are faithful. To the honest man, you are honest. Toward the pure, you are pure. But to the perverse, you are devious. For humble people, you save. Haughty eyes, you bring low. For you, Lord, give light to my lamp. My God brightens my darkness. With you, I can rush an armed band. With my God to help, I can leap a wall. God's way is unerring. The Lord's promise is refined. He is a shield for all who take refuge in him. Truly, who is God except the Lord? Who but our God is the rock? This God who girded me with might, kept my way unerring, who made my feet like a deer's and set me on the heights, who trained my hands for war, my arms to string a bow of bronze. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. People of God, my friends, we are praying Psalms. If you follow me and join in prayer with me, by the end of 150 Psalms, you would have prayed the whole book of Psalms. And so that's the benefit. Have you ever prayed these Psalms, all Psalms in your life? So if you have not prayed, this is the time to join. And see, in the letter to the Ephesians, St. Paul in chapter 5, verses 19 and 20, he says, with psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs. All right? So even saints exhort us to pray the psalms. And we can sing lots of songs. We can be happy with what type of music you like, but psalms are most spiritual songs. So we'll pray always in this psalm that we just read, Psalm 18, part 2. For you, O Lord, give light to my lamp. My God brightens my darkness. In the days when there was no electricity, people used lamps, with oil lamps, right? And so if there is no oil, then you don't have light. Even when you use candles and the wax is gone down, the light also diminishes. And if there is no light in the darkness, you cannot act and work. Similarly, in the psalm, David tells us that if there is no light in ourselves, the lamp of our life is going to be in dark. That's why God has to bless us with His light, so that He can illumine our life, our body, our soul, and brighten so that we can live happily and joyfully. So pray during this time for the light of Christ, so that Christ may dwell in you and illumine you. Let us pray. Lord God, we ask you to send us the light of Christ, your dear beloved Son, only begotten Son of God, into us, in our lives, so that He can dispel the darkness of sin and enlighten us so that we can see you clearly and follow you. In the precious name of Jesus, amen. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. Thank you for joining me in this prayer. If you are blessed by this time of prayer, please click on the like, share, or subscribe button and share with others. May God bless you.